Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. So for today's video, I am collaborating with one of my girls, which I will be mentioning in just a few seconds. I am celebrating, or should I say, we are both celebrating our 500 subscribers on our YouTube channel. And this is so exciting. I'm collaborating with Jessica, and she is such a lovely, gorgeous YouTube friend that I met, and we're celebrating our 500 subscribers because we sort of got 500 subscribers at the same time, and it was just such a reason to collab and sort of celebrate together. I will be linking her YouTube channel down below in the description. I'll also be showing you guys her social media account on the screen, and yeah, you should totally follow her. We have made such good friends in the time that we've met. We actually met on YouTube and she's absolutely stunning. Her makeup videos are just to die for. Jessica did decide to do a little colorful work of art makeup tutorial for you guys, which is what I'm wearing on my face right now, and I will be showing you guys in just a second. So without further ado, let's get into this tutorial. Hey guys, so to celebrate this look, as I mentioned just a few seconds ago, me and Jess decided to film a colorful makeup tutorial. So the palette I am using right now is from Essence Cosmetics. It's the Disney collection. They released 5 different palettes, 4 of them being eye palettes and the 5th one being a contouring palette. So the palette I decided to start off with for this eye look is the Ariel palette. This palette is absolutely beautiful. The color story is very ocean-based, a lot of blues and greens to complement the ocean, and then some coral colors too, especially this yellow. So next off, I decided to use this Huda Beauty dupe, ordered from AliExpress. On this palette, I am using the Neon Lime shade to blend in with the previous yellow I just applied. So this is actually the first time I have used this palette. I ordered it and kind of just left it to one side for a couple of months, and I did not expect the pigment to be this good. So now, coming back to the Essence Cosmetics Ariel palette, I will be applying the bottom corner green. This shade was absolutely stunning. So I know I mentioned this in a lot of my videos, but I just wanted to let you lovelies know that all the Essence Cosmetics beauty range is animal cruelty free. So now, still using the Ariel palette, I will be applying the blue shade to continue this eye look. This blue was such a vibe for me. The blue just reminds me of my love for the ocean and summer. The pigment was actually insane, and crazily enough, I'm actually obsessed with the look on my brush once I applied the color onto it. I thought it looked so pretty. I honestly did not expect this blue to be as pigmented as it actually turned out to be. So coming back in with the Ariel palette, I am now using the purple shade to blend in to the outer corner of my eye. This purple gave me very dreamy vibes. It was such a pastel purple, literally in love with this shade too. So next off, coming in with the Essence Cosmetics Princess Tiana palette, I will be applying the top right pink shade to outshadow the outside of my eye look. So this pink was absolutely stunning. Again, a very pastel pink, although you can definitely add pigment to this shade to make it a deeper pink, as I did for this look. So with this pink, I decided to create a halo around the colors I previously blended. I definitely had so much fun with the shade. It was so easy to blend over the top of the other shades. I actually fell in love with the way it simply applied to my lid. Not to mention that the Tiana palette from The Princess and the Frog has lots of swampy greens and oranges to complement the fairy tale. The Princess Tiana palette is actually one of my favorites from their Disney collection. So next off, I will be coming back in with the Essence Cosmetics Princess Ariel palette to apply the bottom right green shade under my waterline. I am so happy with the way this green shade blended in with the previous pink. I thought the combination of those two shades looked really pretty. So right now, I am currently applying the yellow shade on the Ariel palette to blend in with the green and back around to the yellow until my inner corner. So I am now reapplying the purple shade on the Ariel palette to boost the purple pigment a little bit more. Now that I have finished the eye look, I am curling my lashes so I can then apply some falsies and have them looking as natural as possible. So before I apply my lashes, I decided to give them a bit of a reshaping and trim to make them a little bit more bold. For this, I am using a small cosmetic scissors. This was actually a bit of a hit or miss situation as I had no idea what they'd end up looking like, but I decided to go ahead and try out a new look anyways. So now, showing you lovelies the final result, I will also be applying my falsies. These I actually purchased from AliExpress as a set of 5. So as mentioned in my previous videos, I always use the back end of my smaller brushes to set the lashes the way I want them to. I found that one of the easiest ways for me to apply lashes are with 2 separate tools, one to apply and one to set them with. So next off, I am applying my current favorite mascara, and that is the Essence Cosmetics Gym Proof Mascara. I actually did haul these in one of my last videos, and I will link this up on the screen right now so you can go ahead and check it out. So now I will be finishing the lashes with a different mascara I purchased in a store in Spain called Mercadona. This mascara is super dramatic and voluminous. It is absolutely crazy, and I am obsessed with making big looks with this mascara. You guys, just look and admire this palette from Technique Cosmetics. It's literally one of the prettiest glitter palettes I have ever seen in my life. This is the Technique Cosmetics Pressed Glitter Palette Unicorn Uniform. This retailed for about £5.99. And with this palette, I am using the white pressed glitter as highlighter in my inner corner of my eye and my cheekbones. I am literally obsessed with this palette. It was my first time using it in this video and I genuinely was in love. Next off, I will be using a maroon toned lip liner as eyeliner to complete this look. I feel like this maroon liner really complemented this look. So once again, I literally could not resist, you guys. I am coming back in with the pressed glitter from Technique Cosmetics to reapply it within my inner corners of my eye and cheekbones. So to complete today's look, I will be adding some Primark Beauty Clear Lip Gloss. You guys, I really hope you enjoyed this makeup look. Yeah, I'm super excited, like really excited. I can't believe that I've actually finally reached 500 subscribers. It is honestly something, you guys, I never thought I would reach. And to me, 500 subscribers is such a big number. Like 500 of you guys supporting me on my channel means the world to me. It truly does, because YouTube is what I love doing. It's my drive, it's my motivation. I know I didn't know how it was gonna come out. I did try and get a picture. I'll show you guys a picture on the screen of what I was sort of going for. I did try and get a picture of that whilst I was filming, but then my spare phone died, my laptop died, and I couldn't. So I did my very best to sort of get it right, just out of like memory. I want to try something different with the eyelashes. I don't know why, it was just such an excuse for me to try something different in today's video, considering it's so different to my usual videos. Just note, you guys, thank you so much for helping me reach my goal. I mean, it wasn't really a goal because I never thought I would reach 500 subscribers, but you guys have made that real. Your support has been amazing beyond words. No sort of words would even be able to match out how much I actually appreciate you guys and how much I appreciate you supporting me. That is just such a wonderful thing to do, supporting someone and doing what they love. And yeah, I think you guys are absolutely wonderful. A little bit of background information on me and Jess. We actually met via YouTube. Checked out, I can't remember who contacted who first, but we sort of just found each other. And obviously we commented on each other's video, we were supporting each other, and we just started talking, followed each other on Instagram, and we just had such a good vibe between us. I remember posting a story thanking you guys for helping me reach my 500 subscribers, and a few minutes later she literally posted one because she had just reached her 500 subscribers. I was like, oh my god, like no way, like we've literally just hit 500 subscribers on the same day, girl, like should totally collab. I had so much fun creating this video. I had no idea I could even pull a look like this off. Like, this is the first time I tried it, no joke, you guys. I was actually, when I first saw it, I sent it to Jess. I was like, what do you think about this look? And she was like, I was thinking the same thing. We were both wanting to create a very, well, practically the same look without even knowing each other that well. It was literally crazy. So you guys, I hope you enjoyed today's collaboration video. I hope you liked today's makeup tutorial, and I really hope to see you guys in my next videos. Thank you so much for just being here and supporting me on my journey. Make sure to hit that big red subscribe button, turn notifications on, and give this video a big thumbs up. And you lovelies, I shall see you in my next videos.